Welcome to this audio flip chart on noise trader risk. My name is Manfred Frühwirth. I am professor of finance at WU Wien, which is Vienna University of Economics and Business. The purpose of this audio flip chart is to show you one important reason why arbitrage by smart investors does not automatically make the security prices adjust to the fundamental values, as argued by neoclassical finance. Behavioral finance provides several explanations for this. These explanations are included under the umbrella term limits to arbitrage. One very essential mechanism is noise trader risk. This audio flip chart will focus on noise trader risk in a situation of undervaluation. I want to show this at the example of a stock. For a stock, as for every security, conceptually, we have to distinguish between the price and the fundamental value. The price is what you can observe at stock exchange. This is the amount that you have to pay if you are buying the security and the amount that you get if you are selling the security. The fundamental value, however, is the true value of the stock. This is also called the fair value or intrinsic value. You can determine the fundamental value by performing a sound valuation of the stock, for instance, by discounted cash flow valuation or by using the dividend discount model. On this flip chart, we have on the horizontal axis the time. As we are going to the right, time elapses. On the vertical axis, we have the price and the fundamental value. Now, let us imagine we are in a situation of undervaluation. Therefore, the price, symbolized by the black P, is smaller than the fundamental value, symbolized by FV. According to neoclassical finance, the consequence would be that smart investors observe this undervaluation. As a result, they buy the undervalued stock. As sooner or later, and neoclassical finance thinks rather sooner than later, the price will have to converge to the fundamental value. The arbitrageur only has to wait until the price has increased towards the fundamental value, and then can realize an arbitrage profit by selling the stock. On this flip chart, we assume that the price hits the fundamental value at time t. So ideally, the arbitrageur buys the stock at time 0 at the original price p, waits until time t, and then sells the stock at the price fv. The arbitrage profit is the difference between the future price, which is the fundamental value, and the original price. This is shown on the flip chart as profit. This is the neoclassical argumentation shown in black. In contrast to neoclassical finance, behavioral finance argues, and practical experience shows, that sometimes it may take quite some time until the price has converged to the fundamental value. Therefore, the arbitrageur has to wait until he can cash in his arbitrage profit. The problem is that during that time, many things may happen. For instance, it may happen, as shown in red, that irrational investors, so-called noise traders, independent of the high fundamental value, become even more pessimistic. As a result, they are selling the stock and thereby drive the price even further down to the level of the red P. So even though the price will finally go up to the fundamental value, before that, due to the noise traders, the undervaluation of the stock gets even stronger. If the arbitrageur can wait until the price has increased to the fundamental value, this does not represent a problem. The problem is that sometimes arbitrageurs do not have the endurance to wait until the price has converged to the fundamental value. While the price is driven even further away from the fundamental value, the arbitrageur is running more and more losses. If we imagine that the arbitrageur is a hedge fund or an investment fund, it may well be that its investors lose their confidence and start returning their shares to the fund, and thereby put pressure on the arbitrageur to close his arbitrage position at time T. In that case, the arbitrageur has to sell the stock at the price, here the red P, that is lower than the price at which he has originally bought, the black P. This, of course, creates a loss for him in the amount of the old wrong price minus the new, even wronger price. This loss is shown on the flip chart. Of course, you could easily draw a similar chart for the case of overvaluation. The arbitrageur would sell the stock short at time zero, wait for the price to decline towards the fundamental value, and then buy back the stock at a lower price. Noise trader risk means that the noise traders may drive up the price even more before the arbitrage strategy is successfully closed, and the arbitrageur has to buy back the stock prematurely at a higher price. By the way, noise trader risk is also illustrated very well by the quotation, "The market can stay irrational longer than you can stay solvent." Similarly, John Maynard Keynes said, "There is nothing so disastrous as a rational investment policy in an irrational world." Looking into finance history, you can see that such things happened several times and led to spectacular problems, near bankruptcies, and even bankruptcies of arbitrageurs. One very striking example is the collapse of the famous hedge fund Long-Term Capital Management in fall 1998. Summing up, the learning outcome of this audio flip chart is, as a smart investor, even if you make everything correctly and perform an arbitrage strategy as described in standard finance textbooks, you may end up losing money simply because noise traders drive the price even further away from the fundamental value, the capital market takes too long to level out the mispricing, and you do not have the endurance to wait until the price finally converges to the fundamental value. In turn, this may lead to the situation that smart investors do not even dare to perform arbitrage strategies, even if the price deviates from the fundamental value. This has one important implication, namely that in contrast to the neoclassical finance framework, we can no longer rely on the fact that smart arbitrageurs make the security prices converge to the fundamental values quickly, and that on the capital market, the prices reflect the true values. I hope you enjoyed this audio flip chart. Thank you for watching.